Hey everybody, what's going on? How's it going? I'm tired, I'm trying to sound energetic though. I figured out a couple cool things today about podcasts and audio stuff. So we're going to try those today. How are you guys? Did you enjoy my thoughts on the gorilla? As if that hasn't been smashed into your head 400 fetching billion times already today. Golly. Let's get over it. Do something else. But welcome to another episode. This is episode 16? Maybe. I can't remember. 16 or 17 of A Face for Radio. I am your host. The host. The one and only. Andrew Latham. How are you guys? How's your week going? It's almost the weekend. Well, actually, no. Well, when you hear this, it will not be anywhere close to the weekend. But where I am now, it is closer to the weekend. I'm pretty sure a lot of you have things to do on the weekend, so it's not really, you know, like it matters or anything. But whatever. Today's going to be hopefully a short show. I say that all the time, don't I? And it never is it? Does that make me a liar? It might. We'll talk about that. But I've gotten some emails about some advice. Yes, in fact, I have. Strangely enough. They must not know me that well. Or else they know me really well. But we've got two advice emails. And then we've got my opinion on something. Because my opinion obviously isn't being told enough on this show. And let's just get into it. Oh, surprise at the end of the show. So hang in there, kids. It's going to be good. It's going to be good. Let's just get to this first email. I wish I could. Oh, do you guys hear that? This is a good mic. It picks up everything. I wish I could read my computer screen and talk into the microphone at somewhat the same, like looking at the same direction, but I can't, because if I put my microphone too close to my computer, then it, oh, that's my stupid phone. You can hear the whatchamajigger fan, because it's a loud piece of garbage. I think I've had it for like 5 years, so. But anyways, here we go. First email comes to us. Signed, hey buddy, you're not my friend, guy. Okay, so it says, dear Andrew, I know you personally, and you have made a lot of mistakes with women. I do not want to make as many as you do. Please tell me the top three things you would tell a single male to avoid doing to ensure that I do not end up alone for the rest of my life like you will. Sincerely, hey buddy, you're not my friend, guy. So, dear hey buddy, you're not my friend, guy. That is true. And due to my insomnia and overthinking and general staying in my head all day because I am driving all day and have nothing else to do, because I sure as hell am not telling my Japanese customers about what effing mountain that is, because nobody knows what it's called. Shut up and go back to sleep. But I came up with three things. If you're, and this actually, these do not apply to women. These apply to men. But if there were three pieces of advice I could give to a single man who wants to be in a relationship, a good one, this is probably what I would. And they're struggling because they can't get a second date. Not that I have that problem. But let's just say I know someone who does. And I talked to him, and this is what he told me. First one. Don't take advice from other women. Any and all dating advice should be received from close male associates whom you have vetted and trust, okay? Don't take dating advice from women. That's fraternizing with the enemy, and nothing they say will make sense to you, and it won't make anything better, okay? And here's why. All women are 100% exactly different from each other in every single way. All over the world. There's not a single woman who they don't share any traits. They might like, I don't know, quinoa and acai bowls or something, but when it comes to like dating or how to get one to like you, they're all 100% different. They all think 100% differently. Okay? Okay. Sorry, I'm texting someone. It's not who you think it is. So, that'd be my first piece of advice. Don't listen to women because they don't even have your best interest in their, they don't have your best interest as their interest. Like, they're not interested in helping you, okay? So that would be my first advice. If you need to say, hey, you know, I'm going on a first date with this girl, what should I do? Don't ask your friends that are girls. Don't ask your friends' wives. Don't ask your sister. Talk to your buddies. And if you don't have any friends, ask me. Like this young man's doing. I'll help you. If I can. I can tell you what not to do. Oh, so that would be it. Do not fraternize with the enemy, okay? Piece of advice number two is learn how to make a good first impression. You know, women are the most judgmental people on the planet. And that's one reason why they like to meet new people, is so they can judge them. And then they can't make any new friends because all they're doing is judging people, which is why they need to meet new people. It's this cycle, okay? So you need to learn how to make a good first impression. You can do this by avoid being yourself. Or when they ask you questions, you can give vague, milquetoast answers to all of her questions. If she asks you what kind of music you like, don't tell her what music you like. Just say you like everything, okay? It's important to be as bland as possible. That way you can cover all the bases as to what this woman would like. And that way you can ask her questions and go, what music kind of do you like? And hopefully she'll be the exact opposite of you and not a bland, boring piece of human trash. And then if she says, oh, you know, I like electronica hip hop, you can say, oh, waiter, I'll take the check. They'll be separate. You can wave to her and say, see ya. You know, if she says country music, you can say, oh, wow, that's cool. Do you have a pair of Daisy Dukes? You know, that would be an acceptable follow-up question, you know. If she says, you know, that she also just likes everything, then you also need to get out of there because that means she doesn't have an opinion and that means she's stupid. Now, it's different for you because you're emotionally unavailable and you're putting walls around yourself so you don't get hurt. And that's different, okay? So, make a good first impression. You're going to want to consult someone about what you wear on a first date. You know, put on get a cologne. Don't put on Axe. If it's an aerosol form, do not use it, okay? You're a grown effing man. Please go to Macy's or somewhere and pick out a cologne. Aqua di Gio is it's a classic, you know. It's a classic. Just go with that. But if it is sold in an aerosol can and costs less than $50, you don't want it, okay? Get a date outfit and just use that for dates. Don't, you know, start dressing like that all the time because that's just way too much money in clothes. But get a good outfit. If you have hair, comb it. Basically, you want to avoid her knowing who you actually are. That's the whole point of the first impression, is you have to hide everything about you, okay? So, you know, make sure you don't reveal your true sense of humor. Basically, the first impression is, it's a lie. That way you can sneak in and get a second date. And then you can, you know, wrap your barbs around her and slowly just destroy her soul so that you're the best thing that she thinks she can get. Excuse me, I'm parched. Okay, so the good first impression, that is very important. Like I said, you've got, you know, an hour to show her that she's not going to end up in a shelf under your bed for the next 10 years, okay? What else with first impression? Clean your car just a little bit, you know? Get some Febreze, for heaven's sakes. That seat has absorbed 10,000 farts. Do her a favor and please clean your vehicle, you know? But yeah, the most important part about the first impression is not being yourself at all in any way, okay? And then the third one that I would give out is you have to stay out of your head, okay? After the first date, after you've texted or talked or whatever, stop evaluating everything she says. In fact, stop caring. You have to be apathetic, right? Let her overthink everything. Let her think, oh, should I put a winky face or a smiley face? Should I end this with a period or an exclamation point? How many exclamation points? You let her worry about that because you're busy replaying Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 and that opening scene where you mow down a bunch of Russian people in an airport is important because, you know, it's pretty sweet. Also, Seinfeld is on in an hour and your phone has to charge, okay? So stay out of your head. Don't overthink things. In fact, don't even think about them. In fact, forget about her and don't even ask her on a second date, okay? So if you don't want to be alone the rest of your life like me, this is my advice. Don't take advice from women. Learn how to make a good first impression and then never think about her ever again, okay? Oh, excuse me, guys. I'm so sorry for my rudeness. But you follow those three steps, you will be successful in this life in dating women, and you will one day wake up next to someone and wonder what the hell you've done. So thank you, Canadian guy. Let's go to this next one. Let me know how that works out, by the way. Send me an email. Let me know how that works if you're ever capable of getting a date and if you can get a second one. And what techniques you have found that help you, okay? Next one says, Dear Andrew, hey, how's it going? I need another man's opinion on this, as all my other male friends are married and ceremoniously chopped their balls off and handed them over to their wives. As such, they can no longer be trusted to give a man's opinion. So please help a brother out. I'm recently married, about 6 months now, to a wonderful woman whom I've known for almost 3 years. I like to go shooting and haven't done much since we've been married because financially speaking, things have been pretty tight. But now that I finished school and I'm working now, I have the money to go buy ammo, etc., to go shooting. I do ask my wife if it's okay if I go shooting by myself early Saturday mornings. I'd go with my friends, but they're too busy being ballless. She says, yeah, sure, but when I get back, I can tell that she's upset. She's passive-aggressive and quiet. And she is usually a very bright and bubbly person. I ask her what's wrong, and she, of course, says nothing. She is okay with guns in the home, as we have had this discussion before we got married. She only does this when I go shooting, so I'm thinking maybe she doesn't like guns anymore and wants them gone? To be honest, I'm not sure at all what's going on. Any insight from a single male would be very helpful. Love the show. Keep it up. Sincerely, none of your damn business. Well, none of your damn business. Here's what's going on. As someone who's studied the female mind for years now, I've cracked the code on a couple things. Number one, they all love... I can't remember. Anyways, let's get into it. So, the reason she's a little cold after this, the reason she's a little passive-aggressive and a little upset with you is because You need to include her in your hobby, pal. You need to do it as much as you can because women spend a lot of time in their heads, okay? And they worry about what other people think, including, you know, you. So the fact that you didn't ask her to go with you, in her mind, sends a red flag. You know, she's wondering, how come he didn't invite me? What did I do to make him not want to spend time with me? What is so great about shooting by himself that he would rather do that than we? What am I doing wrong? Am I not pretty anymore? Am I blah, 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 blah. And then shoot off 1,000 more of those, okay? So, she may fear that you are choosing the hobby over time with her, you know, because she's done something to annoy you or upset you, or that you don't love her anymore, or that, you know, 100 million billion other things, okay? Now, to a man, this is kind of strange. You haven't invited her because you probably just assume that she doesn't want to go. I think I only read your email right now. I don't think it said that you've ever invited her again. You said she's okay with guns in the home, but there's nothing here that says that she's gone shooting before, okay? But, you know, even if she's not an outdoorsy person or likes shooting, maybe from times you've gone before, you still have to invite her because that shows that you're thinking about her and that you care about her, okay? So you say you've known her for 3 months, you've been married for about 6, you're still in the honeymoon phase, it's a big adjustment, yada, yada, yada. So you need to communicate to her that you care about her, not only with your words, but through actions too. Such as things like, the biggest one you could do is you can ask her if she wants to go shooting with you, okay? Just invite her, just say, hey, I'm going to go shooting, would you like to come? She may say no, which probably will, and I don't know if she probably will, but it doesn't matter if she says no every time. You still have to invite her, because if you saying, hey, I'm going shooting, and you not inviting her is, in her head, is, he doesn't want me there. How come? Now, you know, a couple years after marriage, it might change where she goes, yeah, I don't even want to effing go, you know, but regardless, you need to invite her, okay? Now, if she decides to come, don't criticize her clothing choice, okay? If she goes out in full makeup, yoga pants, and Ugg boots, don't say, hey, we're going shooting, you don't need to wear that. Just say, hey, you look beautiful, and I'm glad you're coming with you. Because if she doesn't like shooting or if she's scared of it, it's going to be hard for her to understand the male mindset of form of function over form. Right. Okay. So I don't know women that well. Just kidding. I know them in and out, if you know what I'm talking about. But don't say, hey, don't wear those or whatever. Just say, you look great and let's go. Okay. Now, what if she says no? What if she says, no, thank you, dear. You go enjoy and have a good time. Well, you're still not out of the woods, pal. You got some things you need to do, okay? Tell her what time you're going to be back, and then be back at that time. Okay? That's important, because that shows that you care about her, that you're aware of the time, and that you're going to be back. Because if you lose track of time and are just having a lot of fun, then she'll probably start thinking, well, when's he coming back, and he's having so much fun, and I'm not there, and was he ever going to have fun with me again, blah, 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 blah. Or maybe I just know really insecure women, but I don't know. I feel like all women are kind of insecure. Maybe everyone's a little bit insecure. Whatever. But regardless, okay? And this is just effing common effing courtesy. Say, I'll be back in 3 hours, and then be back in 3 hours. Don't be late. Be back in 3 hours. Now, that's good. Let me help you out, buddy. Let me give you a plus. While you're out there, pick some flowers for her, okay? Or on the way home, grab her favorite something. I don't know, chicks like chocolate or, I don't know, if there's a cupcake store, women love cupcakes, overpriced cupcakes, you know? while you're out there, get something for her and bring it back. It doesn't have to be something big. It just be something small. Flowers is great because they're free and chicks love flowers, okay? Because what that does, that shows her, is that while you were out there, you were thinking about her, which is what she wants, okay? You know, you haven't said anything about your wife. I don't know anything about her. But those first few months of marriage, it's still the honeymoon phase. And the little things are going to mean more than the big things, okay? You don't need to woo her every single night with a huge date. Little things like notes, you know, the flowers when you go out shooting. Little things like that are going to renew her confidence that you're committed to this relationship and that you love her, okay? And then in a couple years, she'll be like, get the hell out of the house, you're in the way. So until then, this is what I would recommend you do. I don't think she wants the guns away. I don't think she, you know, is wanting you to stop your hobby. I think that you need to do a better job communicating that you care about her. Oh, guys, why do I sound like this all the time? Oh, my voice. But if I were in your shoes, pal, that's what I would do. Little things, buddy. Notes, flowers. Here's a great one for you fellas out there. Start writing her a story one day at a time on a little notepad, and then get her a notebook to, oh no, sorry, not a notepad, on sticky notes, you know, on the mirror before you leave or whatever, on her car window or something. And, you know, start out once upon a time. Okay, she will freaking love this. And it gives you a whole day to think of what to write next. You know, you don't have to write the whole story in one day. Just once, you know, just one part at a time. Once upon a time, blah, 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 blah. And then you get a fancy-looking book with blank pages. And then she can put those sticky notes in there. She can tape them or, you know, whatever. She can do that. And then, you know, she'll love it. But let me tell you something. Don't you dare effing miss a day. It will screw you over. So be committed. But little things like that, they're going to love that. And by them, I mean women. How much time are we in? Son of a gun, I've been yapping. All right, here's the last one. So, last piece of advice would be to shut up. But there you go, Mr. What was your name? None of your damn business. I hope that advice helps you and your wife and your wonderful marriage. She sounds like a lovely woman. Any woman that lets a guy go shooting by himself, even just lets him, is a quality. That's top shelf lady right there. But Now, so these are questions come from a listener who may or may not have listened to many episodes. Regardless, she's a dear friend. She is the wife of another dear friend, Lisa Pike. How are you? Lisa MacPherson Pike. Wonderful family. He has excellent taste in music. Not as excellent as mine, but it's still pretty good. But anyways, Lisa sent me an email saying these are some questions her and her girlfriends had. And she wanted to know my opinion, as I have lost all ability to filter myself and basically am on the autism scale for mild autism because I am unaware of social situations. So let's get into these questions. These are kind of weird. And she sent this a while back, and because I'm an idiot, I haven't checked my email in a while. By the way, theaffrshow@gmail.com. Let me say that one more time. theaffrshow@gmail.com. If you have questions, comments, suggestions, anything like that, go ahead and send them there. And I promise I'll check it once a day now. I promise I will get back to you. Okay? But these are Lisa's questions, and they're for men. And because I'm an honest man, I will answer them. Question number one from Lisa. Is it true that within the first few minutes of meeting / seeing a girl, a guy will mentally gauge whether or not they'd sleep with her? I have never done that. But my default answer is no. She won't sleep with me. So, maybe. I don't think so, though. I think most guys probably think about, like, what they look like naked. Not if they'd sleep with them. But again, my default answer is no, they won't sleep with me. So, I'll ask some buddies. Most of my friends are married. God, do I know any single people? I'm so old. I'm not that old. But I don't think so. Oh, wait, hold on. Shit. I mean, shoot. A guy will mentally gauge whether or not the man would sleep with her. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah. That happens. And it's not like, a fantasy thing. It's just basically, if she said, let's go do it, would you say yes or no? Then yes, it is true. I would say that most men do that. Single men. I'm not sure married men do it. But, yeah, definitely, yes. That is 100% correct, Lisa. Her next question is, what is the sexiest thing a girl can wear? How about the unsexiest? Is that correct grammar? Concerning correct grammar, if my sister Marie listens to this one, she will. She's the grammar knowing lady. She's studying linguistics, so I'm sure she'll be able to. Excuse me. Let me know. I have no idea. I think it is unsexiest, insexiest, incestiest. I think unsexiest is all right. The sexiest thing a girl can wear. A Pantera t-shirt. No. I don't know. I think I am okay. Let's go to the unsexiest things. Things that I don't really understand why women wear would be a strapless shirt or like a strapless dress, like a tube top. But if it's strapless, if it's basically held up by sitting on top of your boobs, I don't understand that. That's not attractive at all. It just squishes your boobs now. I don't get it. It doesn't appeal to me at all. Are there guys out there who get, their jollies off of women's shoulders being unencumbered by a millimeter wide piece of cloth? I have never understood the strapless thing. Red lipstick is another thing that I don't get. Like clown red fire truck lipstick. Are they trying to be like Marilyn Monroe, who should not be a role model for any sort of woman? Like, she wasn't even that pretty. I mean, she wasn't ugly, but yeah, don't wear red lipstick. What are some other unsexy things? Hipster glasses piss me off. Those thick glasses. I think glasses are attractive on a woman, but those hipster glasses make me. I just know that I'm going to say the gender wage gap is a myth and it's going to piss her off. So that is annoying. Don't wear those. The high-hipped jeans, I don't get, but they're not that bad. Well, I guess a woman doesn't have testicles, so she doesn't have to worry about choking her non-testicles, but yeah, I forget about that. I forget that women don't have testicles sometimes. Maybe I should spend more time with women, if you know what I'm talking about, but I don't have that much money. You know what I'm saying? Other unsexy things that they wear. Leopard print. Actually, animal print. If it's anything animal print, I'm turned off immediately. She could have a banging body and a leopard print, a thong or boy shorts, and I just, yeah, not interested. That's like trailer trash, clothing items. Leopard. Ugh. It's like those You ever see those people sell those blankets on the side of the road? They're hung up on the wire fence. And it's like three wolves howling at the moon and a Native American with a buffalo coming out of their peace pipe. Or there'll be the jaguar stalking. And they're like, who the hell buys that? Who is so... I mean... Yeah, if you click NASCAR dinner plates, those blankets might be good for you. But if you are not a complete and utter idiot, if you have all your teeth, then you probably shouldn't be buying those. You know? If you don't have all of your teeth, then I could, you know, I could see that. But leopard print anything is... Well, no, sorry, not leopard print. Animal print. Zebra print, leopard print, whatever. Those are all super turn-off-y. So what do we have? Animal print things, red lipstick, strapless things. Anything else? Beanies that don't fit, but that doesn't stick just with women. Guys who do that piss me off too. I think that's it. I know later I'm going to think of like four things. And this is why I need to have someone to do this with, because then we can go back and forth. Capris kind of piss me off, but I don't know why. But they're not like unsexy. Yeah, that's pretty. Yeah, I think those four things would be the unsexiest. Those would be things that would distract me from her beauty. If she had any of those things, that would distract me. As far as the sexiest things, I'm going to sound like a huge pervert when I start talking about this, but knee-high socks are pretty boss, especially Argyle pattern. Thigh-high socks, but I don't know why you'd be wearing thigh-high socks. I mean, those are special-purpose socks. What are other sexy things? Nothing. It's pretty sexy if you were wearing that. I guess, like, if I saw a girl... Like, okay, like, let's say, like, I had a girlfriend or was in a relationship, and she was wearing something, and I would be like, oh, snap. Oh, damn. It would have to be, pretty much anything. Yeah, pretty much anything. Everything but the unsexy stuff would be sexy. We'll have to cover this again with another friend, because I just don't want to sound like I'm a huge pervert. Because I may or may not be, but... screw it. Nobody listens to the show. I'll just say it. The socks, footwear, nothing really, you know, gets me going or not going. I unless you consider socks footwear, which I guess you should, because you wear them on your feet. We'll just move up the body. Underwear, everything is great. Everything is fine. But I think the sexiest underwear would be, I don't know, thongs, I guess. They're all the same. They're all the same. Moving up, t-shirts are fine. Dresses, summer dresses are really nice. Skirts are nice. Again, yeah, everything. I'm a man. It's all great. So, I can't think of anything. Stay away from the unsexy stuff, and then everything else is pretty much sexy. But if you ever talk to a man, they'll say some things that you'll think, wow, this guy is a pervert. Because they'll be like, oh, you know, a green jacket with gold buttons that goes just past the elbows, and her lapel is 3 3/4 inches wide at the top with the 15 degree angle coming down south by southwest at a 40 knot. You know, things like that. And that's weird, but I don't have anything like that. Yeah. Stay away from red lipstick, strapless stuff, What was the other ones? Animal prints. And, oh, big gaudy sunglasses are also distracting and irritating. We called them deceivers when I worked at BMW because you couldn't tell if she was ugly or not if she wore them because they were so big. Or, no, those are fine, I guess. Yeah. Is there anything else? No, girls can get away with a lot of stuff. Or maybe I just have low standards. Or maybe I'm just easily turned on. Or maybe I'm not easily turned off. Or maybe I don't care. Or maybe a combination of all that. But, yeah. Alright, next question. How often does a guy see his girl / woman talking closely with another girl and imagine them kissing? I don't know. Wow. The hell are you guys talking about? Golly. I have never imagined that. I've never imagined when I was in a relationship, back when there was hair on my head, I never watched her talking with another woman and thought like, oh yeah, it's gonna happen. I would say never. Yeah. Never. How often does a guy see his with another and imagine them kissing? Yeah, never. If I saw my wife or girlfriend kissing another girl, I'd be worried. I'd be like, oh great, now I'm dating a lesbian. What the F? You know? But, yeah. Okay, last question. Oh, wait, last. When you ask a guy how you look and he says fine, does he really mean it? Yeah. Yeah, again, I think guys see there's a few negatives and then everything else is positive. So, besides, what the hell do you think he's going to say? Do you think he's going to be, if you put on a leopard print dress, red makeup, a red lipstick, and then, God, what were the other ones? Oh, and the dress is strapless. And if my wife said, what do I look like or how do I look? I'd probably say fine. Because I'd rather look at that than have her be pissed off at me for the next 6 months because I say, you know, why don't we try something else? You know? But I think most men are, you know, everything is good except, you know, A, B, C, and D, right? So if you're wearing jeans and a t-shirt, then and you say, how do I look? He'll probably say, yeah, you look good. Because unless the t-shirt says, you know, what kind of t-shirt would piss me off? BYU? I don't know. Nah, it wouldn't piss me off. But you know what I mean? There's the default is good. And then there's a few bumps in the road, maybe. But default is smooth sailing. So I would say yes. I would say that when you ask a guy how you look and he says fine, does he really mean it? I would say that he really does mean it. Because he's already attracted to you regardless of what. I mean, you could be throwing up in the bathroom, bloodshot eyes, puke all over your mouth and face. And if you said, let's make out. I mean, there's like a 50% chance that he'd be okay, you know. Let's get some Listerine in your mouth real quick and then let's get going. But I don't think, you know, there's not a whole lot that's going to stop a guy. But yeah, so yes, Lisa, I believe that that 99.9% of the time when he says you look fine, he does 100% mean it. And then the last thing, what are the top three attributes a guy wants in a girl? Be honest. Now, I can't speak for all men because not all men are as good as me, but I would say that most men agree with me with this, especially most men that you'd probably interact with, Lisa. Hold on, I'm parched. Oh, that's refreshing. I would say the top three attributes that a guy would look for in a woman is, number one, a sense of humor. Because a sense of humor also relays that she is smart and easygoing. that she's not going to get her panties in a knot over everything. So I would say a sense of humor. And then I would say forgiving. You know? I think forgiving would probably be another one, because he's probably going to make, well, she will too, but make a lot of mistakes, and he really doesn't need it being brought up every 3 weeks. So forgiving, and, or the three that I look for would be sense of humor, laid backness, I guess, a girl who's easy to get along with and easygoing, someone who's down to do pretty much whatever. You know, she's not going to be super picky concerning activities, as in, well, how come we don't go here, or I hate this place, we're never going here, things like that. You know, there's always somewhere with, like, there will always be some places, but if you say she's equally down to go on a road trip as she would be to watch reruns of Hey Arnold with you on your couch, that's what I'm talking about. And then thirdly, I would say that the next attribute would be, I can't say honest, because there's no such thing as an honest woman, but what would the third next most desirable attribute be? I mean, is kind too vague? Yeah, I think it is. Is appreciative too vague? Thoughtful too vague? I'd say thoughtful. You know, that she is as attentive to his needs as he is to hers. So, no, this is it. The next, the third top one would be, I don't know what the attribute is, but she doesn't want to change him. So, you know, if he says, if it's his birthday and he goes, let's go get Taco Bell for dinner, she doesn't go, you know, F that, we're not going to Taco Bell for your birthday. She goes, you know, if she rolls her eyes and says, okay, that's, you know, that's fine. That wouldn't bother me. But my birthday was bogarted this year by some dumb chick, and we had to go down to some butthole diner in Podunk, crap hole, USA, and eat crappy food. And I just wanted Taco Bell.
Taco
Bell. So, yeah, maybe he does want stupid things. Maybe he wants things that you don't want him, that you want to get him better stuff. Maybe you wanted to go out to dinner and get dressed up, but guess what? It's not your birthday, it's his birthday. So if the man wants Taco Bell, and he wants to watch, you know, the first season of Pokemon, then, hey, it sounds pretty good, pretty grateful. I mean, it's an easygoing dude. So I think those three, a good sense of humor, what was number two? Oh, balls. A good sense of humor, laid backness, I think was number two. And then not changing him, I think one of the most endearing things a woman could ever do is roll her eyes and sigh and then just do it instead of, you know, like bitch and moan for the next little while. Rolling your eyes and sighing that's another way of saying I love you. That's a way of saying I think you're really stupid, but I love you. So that would be it. How long was this episode? Oh, that's not bad. We're just about where I wanted to be. So thank you, Lisa, for those. I will try and get some more males in. And you know what? I've got some females. We'll see. But thank you for that. I hope you guys enjoyed this show. This is a little bit different than what I've done before. But if you didn't like it, well, go to hell. Nobody cares what you think. And if you did like it, well, of course you did. I did it, and everything I do is awesome and great and perfect. But, let's get to the end. Okay, so, I figured out how to add audio files. And so what I'm going to start doing is every couple episodes, maybe every episode, at the very end, I'm going to put on a song that I really like. Now, I really like heavy metal music. I listen to heavy metal, classic rock, and classical is generally what I listen to. A little bit of everything else spattered. I really like John Denver, too. But I recently went to a concert. I saw Lamb of God, and Clutch and Corrosion of Conformity opened, and I never heard Clutch before, and Clutch was really good. I knew of Corrosion of Conformity, but this was the first time I had seen them live, and it was great. Lamb of God was, of course, awesome. But a lot of people have inferior taste in music, and they don't know about all this awesome music out there like I do. So I figured I would end the show every show with a new song that maybe you guys would like. The song I'm going to do at the end of this is called Albatross by Corrosion of Conformity. Corrosion of Conformity started out as a metal band in the 80s. In 1989, the rhythm guitarist Pepper Keenan joined. In 91, he took over as the vocalist and lead guitarist, and they went from like heavy metal to more of a bluesy rock. Pepper is from New Orleans, and in 91, he also joined a band called Down, which was headed by Philip Anselmo. It still is headed by Philip Anselmo, who is also the lead singer of Pantera, which is no longer a band, but Phil Anselmo also is the lead singer and the lead vocalist for Philip Anselmo and the Illegals, Superjoint, formerly Superjoint Ritual, now called Superjoint, and Down. So those three. But this song, Albatross, is a really good, medium tempo, bluesy rock. I'm not sure what the song is about, but it's a really good song, and I hope you guys enjoy it, and I hope you guys have a good week, kind of. I mean, I'm not sure if you will, but I hope you do. And I will be, when you hear this, I will be in Teton National Park with two older Japanese people trying to fill up every single day with activities. I will record a show while I'm there. Oh, I'm going to sneeze. Oh, nope. Hold on. Wait. Nope. Oh, okay, I'm good. So you hear about that. But thank you for listening. Take my advice. It's great advice. All I do is think all day. So that's why I'm so smart. And enjoy this song. This is, again, Albatross by Corrosion of Conformity. You all have a wonderful week.